the Big East Player of the Year, but Smith Rivera, he's the glue on his team. When they need a basket, they go to him. Similar when Seton Hall needs a basket, they go to Gibbs. Or the Friars need a basket, they go to Dunn or Dante Henton. So I think the key to the game, John, is the big guy Smith inside, the other Smith. He's the guy that everything goes through him on the offensive end. And when he gets positioned, he usually scores, and he's a good passer out of that big out of that position. Friars had him in foul trouble in the last game. We're able to take advantage inside and won in overtime, but he's a guy that you really have to find where he is on the floor. He's a big dude. You can find him. You just have to keep him off the glass.
Friars in the road blacks tonight with silver-gray numerals and lettering, silver and white trim. Georgetown in the home gray uniforms with the dark blue lettering, dark blue numerals, and dark blue patterned trim on the sides of the gray uniforms. So the gray against the black, and the Big East officiating crew tonight features Pat Driscoll, Tom Eads, and Paul Zelk, somebody that we have not seen yet. So it'll be interesting to see what your Hassett factor might be tonight.
Well, we'll give him a shot. We won't talk about him yet. We couldn't even pronounce his name yet. And then he got you the name. He said, what kind of letters are these?
Well, it's because he's got the hieroglyphics going.
Oh, man, he's tough. Big John Thompson, who's in the house, and he'll be in Providence next week as they retire his number at the Dunkin' Donuts Center.
Yeah, that'll be interesting to have him back home, and great that he would allow that to happen at his alma mater at Providence. All right, we're getting set to go as television joins us. It will be Josh Smith, Carson DeRozier, and the tip is controlled by the Hoyas. And Georgetown goes basket to our right on the radio here at half number one. The Friars open up in a man-to-man. Peek has the ball up high onto the right wing for Smith Rivera, and he's guarded there by Lumumba. Into the right corner for Trawick. He's going to go up for three, and what did we just say? He just canned a three from the corner.
Well, you know, they backed off a little bit. Trawick is a guy that, you know, he's shooting 39%. Doesn't look like he's a good shooter, but he makes the shot.
46% outside the arc in the season. He just doesn't shoot it much. Friars break pressure into the forecourt to our left. Basket to our left here in the opening half as Georgetown scores on their first shot of the ball game and leads 3-0. Dunn takes a dribble to the right side against a man defense. Henton gives it back to Dunn. Feeds the post for DeRozier, and he's open for a dunk.
Boy, nice setup right there. Friars didn't attack the press to score. They knew where they wanted to go. Get it to DeRozier early.
Trawick, right side for Smith. Rivera, top of the key for Hopkins. On the high post, shares with Smith. Back out for Hopkins. Rolls right off of the screen. Onto the right wing. Peek back to Hopkins. Drive to the free throw line. Left. Trawick fakes the three. Drives on Henton in the lane. Puts it up, has the ball knocked out of bounds. Georgetown will keep it with 17 to shoot.
See, that three-pointer by Trout, now it opens up the whole game for him. You have to go out and respect the outside shot. He wants to get to the basket. That's what he really wants to do. Got a pump fake, got to the basket. Good defense by the Friars.
Inbounds comes to the right side. Smith Rivera now controls off the top, pulls it out between the circles. Friars go 2-3 zone off of the inbound. Smith Rivera, deep three off the front of the rim. Rebound is tapped out of bounds. It'll be Providence ball.
Good job boxing out there by DeRozier. Looks like Georgetown wants to press a little bit. Friars have had some problems against the press this year.
1-2-2 zone press by Georgetown. Friars break it easily into the forecourt to our left. Up the right sideline, DeRozier dumps it off to Henton, who gets to the foul line, drives inside on Smith, rolls it up at the rim, won't get it. Rebound is taken by Dunn, but then swiped away by Hopkins. And then a foul is called from behind on Dunn, who collided with Hopkins.
So he was reaching in for the ball, and normally they don't call that, but Dunn picks up a quick one right there. You notice, if you watch tape on the Friars, they've had some problems scoring against the press. You know, they don't attack at the score, and teams realize that now. Maybe they'll keep pressing them and let them back it out.
Hopkins on the right wing with the basketball. Now takes it to the top of the key, and we got to travel. So he threw the ball over to the wing, but took steps where he ever released the ball, and Hopkins turns it over.
Well, Hopkins was thinking about throwing the backdoor pass to Trawick, but Trawick was covered, and then he shuffled his feet, picked up the travel.
Some of that Princeton principal offense that John Thompson likes to run from his days as head coach of the Tigers.
Exactly. That offense works pretty well when there's no shot clock. But when there's a shot clock, you can guard it.
Dunn breaks the pressure into the forecourt, keeping the dribble this time, and he's got Peek, the freshman, guarding him. Rolls right, has the ball knocked away, picked up with a foul line by DeRozier. Back to Dunn. He's going to fire on three and got it blocked. The ball is tipped. DeRozier has it tipped away from him to Peek, and Peek has a jam the other way.
Well, Chris Dunn settling for that outside shot. He's made a couple of those recently, but good defense right there gets the block.
So 5-2 Georgetown, 17:52 to go in the opening half. And again, pressure broken, but there's Smith, who steps right over DeRozier and slaps it away. Smith Rivera for three hits. And Ed Cooley calls a quick timeout.
And Cooley's mad because he wants a foul on that play coming over the back of DeRozier. That's a foul. You see, the Friars aren't playing aggressive offensively, and Georgetown is. Georgetown's looked at three-pointers. Smith Rivera's been out there by 30 feet taking threes. after the steal, the Friars are attacking the press to get it over half court, then run the offense.
Right.
You attack that press to score. You have to go after it. There's no way Smith back there can defend if you get into the lane there because they don't have the foot speed. The Friars have speed. Use it. Attack at the score. Georgetown starts off 3 of 4 and 2 of 3 from beyond the arc. Friars is 1 for 3, but not being aggressive on the offense. You know, you see a press as a player. You get it past midcourt when they're gambling in the backcourt. You have numbers. And if you have those numbers in your offensive half-court game, you're happy with that. You're getting open looks. Well, do it against the press. It's early. Make them pay for pressing you.
Our opening brought to you by Alex and Ani, made in America with love. An 8-2 lead for Georgetown out of the gate. 17:42 to play in the half. Here's Dunn getting by the defender into the forecourt in the middle of the floor and throws the ball away. It goes out of bounds to the far side, and Georgetown will get the ball.
See, again, the Friars haven't been pressed much. Only when they've been ahead in games and teams come back and try to press to get back in, like Xavier did and Georgetown has done. Georgetown comes out pressing right away, and it's worked.
Friars going zone as Pete brings the ball forecourt left for Trollick. Now up high for Smith-Rivera, right wing for Hopkins. Hopkins, Smith-Rivera, top of the key. Now back on the right side for Peek. Peek back to Smith-Rivera, goes left for Trowick. Looks down to the baseline, not there. Smith-Rivera off the top of the key. Finds Hopkins in the middle, dumps it off in the middle. Ball gets knocked loose, picked up, though, by Hopkins in the right post. 10 to shoot, moves to the left, has the shot blocked by DeRozier. The Friars come up with the ball. Up the floor now for Dunn. Dunn has some numbers, drives left, goes hard to the hoop, gets the shot blocked by Peek. And fouled by Peek on the way.
That's what you got to do. Be aggressive. Don't back it out and just run your half-court offense. Get down the court. 50-50 balls the Friars haven't been getting yet either. DeRozier makes a good block there after Georgetown got those 50-50 loose balls. So Friars need to be a little bit more aggressive out there. You got to get a chip on your shoulder coming in here. You have to come in here with an aggressive mentality and take it right to them.
Dunn's free throw bounces and stays as he gets his first point of the night. Big East player of the week now for a second time after getting the 14th triple-double in Big East history against DePaul a week ago. And he's a 67.5% free throw shooter on the season. Dunn, one more try. On the way, and good. So he got them both. It's 8-4. Georgetown in the lead, 17:04 to play. And the Friars go with some 1-2-2 pressure in the backcourt as well on Georgetown. So Peek will bring it up across the midfloor line, left side, on the sideline for Trowick in front of the Friar bench. Trowick pulls it out to Smith-Rivera against the Friar zone. Back to Trowick on the left wing, feeding the post to Smith. Tip stolen by Dunn on a cross-court pass. Dunn drives one on two to the hoop and gets fouled by Smith-Rivera.
That's a one-man fast break right there. Good job by Dunn having his hands up in the passing lane, deflects that pass to himself and takes it down the court and picks up a foul on Smith-Rivera. Good deep.
First foul on Smith-Rivera, second on the Hoyas, and Dunn goes right back to the line for two more free throws after hitting two less than a minute ago. And his first shot is up, and it's off the back of the rim, no good.
I noticed in this game, too, John, Smith-Rivera for Georgetown, he is looking for a shot right away now. In the game against Providence, I don't think he took a shot in the first 8 or 9 minutes of the game. He tried to let the flow happen.
Dunn missed them both. So how do you make two and then miss two in a row? I've never been able to figure that out. The Friars are still down 8-4. Smith-Rivera has it on the wing. Comes left side now for Peek. Peek back now back to Smith-Rivera. Comes right for Trowick. Looks at the Friars zone. Peek comes to the top of the key. Curls off of the screen. Left side of length. Goes up the runner. Won't get it. Now there's Hopkins for a resounding rebound stop.
Well, Hopkins comes down the middle because Pascal Chukwu had to go over and help out on the penetration. His man ends up being the guy getting the dunk.
Chukwu had just come into the game for Carson DeRozier. Here's Bentel with the ball at the top of the key. 10-4 Georgetown with the early lead. Chukwu in the high post. Stops, looks, they're way off of him. And now there's a whistle and a foul called on Smith-Rivera again for holding Junior Lumumba. And that's two fouls on Smith-Rivera.
That's a bad foul by Smith-Rivera. You don't have to worry about Lumumba scoring. He's out there to play defense, and he grabs him coming off a screen and picks up a cheap one.
He's going to stay in the game with two fouls. There's an inbounds to Henton. Top of the key. He's going to fire a three, and it's off the mark. Rebound tapped, no good, and Georgetown with the ball. And here's Trowick on the break, driving right. Smith-Rivera fakes the three, gets into the lane. Nice. Price throws up the runner, throws up an air ball, and there's Chukwu with the rebound.
Good move. He did everything nice there. Just didn't make the shot.
He had to go right at Smith-Rivera. Here's Dunn on the left wing. Tyler Harris has entered the game, and there's a ball lost in the backcourt, and it's off of Smith-Rivera as he and Dunn collide for the ball. That could have been a third foul, but it goes out of bounds. It will stay Providence's ball after a timeout.
That's what Ed Cooley thought. It should have been a foul.
15:44 to play in the opening half. 10-4. Georgetown with the early lead. From Learfield Sports, this is Providence Friar Basketball.
Well, Georgetown has taken twice as many shots as the Friars so far, John. They've taken eight, hit four of them at 50%, two of three from beyond the arc. Friars just 1-for-4, 0-for-2 from beyond the arc. But defensively, the Friars have to get a little bit better out there and not allow those wide-open looks by Georgetown. And also, I feel they need to go out there and attack that press to score. Get something going to the basket. They're settling for the first quick shot they see. And Ladante took a tough three right out of the gate out of the out-of-bounds play. And Ladante's better off pump faking and getting to the basket. That's where he's most effective.
Friars with the basketball. Junior Lumumba will inbound to the near side in the backcourt. And Georgetown has brought in freshman Trey Campbell, 6'2", out of Washington, D.C. And also freshman Isaac Copeland, 6'9", freshman from Raleigh, North Carolina. Lumumba will inbound to the backcourt. Dunn is back there. Henton is back there with him. Inbounds comes to Dunn. He'll bring it up against the freshman Campbell. Dunn in the forecourt to our left. Hands off to Lumumba between the circles. The basketball comes over left on the pass now for Dunn, brings dribble back to the center, penetrates, throws up the floater to Chukwu, who puts it in, falling away, and Chukwu puts it in the hole.
Oh, it's nice to have size. Nice play by Chukwu, getting his balance to tip that one in.
Pascal gets his first basket, Friars within four, as Trawick has it on the right wing against the Friars zone. Peak steps out for Copeland, back again for Peak between the circles, now left for Campbell. Peak again at the top of the key. Goes left for Campbell. Back to Peak. They play catch to the right side with Trawick. In the right corner for Copeland. Drives baseline. Runner up. Air ball. Smith comes down with the ball, and he gets fouled on the floor. And I believe it'll be against Tyler Harris.
Tyler Harris and Pascal Chukwu together don't weigh what Smith weighs. I mean, that's a big guy in there. They have, you know, you say box him out, you just can't move him. He gets to a spot, you're not going to get there. They need to double team him, have one guy in back of him, one guy in front of him when the shot goes up, and hope you can get a hand on it.
Jalen Lindsey's checked in for Junior Lumumba. Georgetown inbounds the ball, fresh shot clock at 35 as they throw the ball from the baseline into Trey Campbell. Again, the Friars go zone off the inbounds, left for Peak. Now Campbell, between the circles, comes right for Trawick. Campbell, Peak, left, drives down to the baseline, gets cut off by Henton. On the wing, back out Campbell, back to Peak again in front of the Friar bench. Now Campbell again, back to Peak. Looks into the left corner. Trawick gets off the three. Missed that one. Smith, offensive rebound. Out to Campbell, back to Copeland. Finds Smith in the post. Works his way in on Chukwu. Blocked by Pascal.
Oh, come on.
And fouled by Pascal.
You know, he leaned his shoulder in that time. Pascal was falling backwards. They usually say when you're falling forward, they call a foul. Pascal went backwards and still blocked the shot. They call a foul on him. Could easily been an offensive foul on Smith, lowering his shoulder into Pascal.
Pascal instead picks up his first foul, third on the Friars. Josh Smith to the foul line. 67% from the line on the season for the senior, and he misses the free throw, averaging 12 points, 6.7 rebounds. He leads the Big East in field goal percentage at 65% from the floor. He's also seventh in the league in rebounding. Second shot for Smith. He is on the way. The line drives it in. That's his first point of the night. And it's 11-6, Georgetown by 5, with 14:33 to play in the first half. Dunn takes it into the forecourt against Campbell toward the Georgetown bench on the far side. Forecourt to our left. Bounce pass to Harris outside the top of the key. Harris guarded by Copeland, goes left wing for Henton. Henton guarded by Trawick, now up high again for Dunn. Comes off the screen right, pops it out to Lindsey, and it's thrown away, picked up by Smith. Up the floor to Campbell, and stolen back by Dunn. Friars have a 3-on-1 as Harris drives the right side, got the shot blocked by Trawick, and it will be free throws for the Friars.
Well, a good steal by Dunn. I mean, he stole that away. George had a 4-on-0. He was back there and got his hand in the lane there. Took a tough fall right there on that pass over to Harris. Good foul by Georgetown to put Harris on the foul line by Trawick.
And Friars had 4-on-1 in that cage, and Trawick on that break, and Trawick fouled Harris, his first, team's fourth, and Tyler to the line for the first time tonight, and he hits the free throw. On the season, Harris averaging 10.6 points, 4.5 rebounds per game, as Carson DeRozier back into the game for Pascal Chukwu. And he's a 70% free throw shooter on the year for the Friars.
Coach Cooley, Pat. Pascal Chukwu on the head. He says, hey, good job. It's a free throw missed by Harris.
In and out. Copa gets the rebound. 11-7 is the Georgetown lead. Hoyas with the basketball. Peak has it to the right wing again for Trawick. Trawick brings it back to the center, goes left for Copa. Looks inside, tipped out of bounds by DeRozier. The pass was intended for Smith down in the block.
Well, they pass it around the perimeter, but they're looking for Smith. They want to get the ball inside to him somewhere. If he gets it in the paint, he's a tough guy to guard in there.
Peek inbounds left corner. Stolen again by Dunn. He comes up with a loose ball. Pushes it up the floor for Jalen Lindsey. Stops from 15. Puts it up and in.
Nice steal by Dunn. He's everywhere. He's guarding the whole team out here for Georgetown. His hands is in the passing lane. He has at least three steals.
Jalen Lindsey gets his first basket. And the Friars are within two. Campbell, top of the key for the Hoyas. Onto the right wing again, Trowick. Back to Campbell. He's going to launch a deep three and pin it.
Well, he was out here early taking a ton of shots. Lights were barely on, and he was out here working on it, and it shows right there. He knocks down that deep one.
Freshman only averages 3 points per game. Got the three there. A 32% shooter outside the arc, and the Hoyas back up by five. Dunn has it left of the key. Backdoor pass for Harris. Scores off the glass.
Good move without the ball that time by Harris. He picked off his man, and Dunn finds him. Dunn's doing everything.
14-11. Providence back within three. We're coming up on 13 minutes to play here in the first half from the Verizon Center in Washington, D.C. Peek, left side, now Campbell goes left for Copeland, back to Campbell to the center, on the right wing for Peek, now goes up with a jumper, 15, misses everything, rebound, Smith has the ball down low, puts it up, blocked by DeRozier, he comes up away with the ball, now Dunn, long pass, forecourt, left wing for Harris, set back outside the three, feeds Dunn for three, hits it, holy moly.
Chris Dunn saying, who's preseason player of the year? I'm the best player on the floor right now, and he's been the best player in the Big East all year, I think.
He's got five, and the Friars have tied the score at 14 for the first time tonight. Friars have made their last four shots from the floor. Copeland goes to Peek, left side for Campbell. Now Campbell brings the ball back to the center, onto the right side for Copeland against the Friars zone. Trowick down on the left corner for Peek. Peek now one dribble, back out to Trowick. Comes to the right wing for Campbell with 11 to shoot. Trowick goes left for Peek, penetrates the stripe, now back out for Trowick again, down to six. Trowick steps, Campbell, 28-footer, got it.
Boy, oh boy, Harris has to get out on him, especially with the shot clock like that. You want him to go by you. You don't want to give up that three.
Trey Campbell is at back-to-back threes, only averages 2.9 points per game, but he has hit a couple of bombs at Georgetown, back up by three. Harris goes left for Dunn, penetrates left all the way through, kicks the ball out for Hinton, and Hinton is fouled by Trowick on his drive to the foul line. And that is two fouls on Jabril Trowick. So both Trowick and Smith Rivera getting in foul trouble with 11:40 to play in the opening half. We have a timeout on the floor. Georgetown 17, Providence 14. From Learfield Sports, this is Providence Friar Basketball.
Radio 103.7 WEEI.
RIPTA is the official public transportation provider for PC Athletics. Get rewards for riding RIPTA. It's free and it's easy to do at newride.com/RIPTA. That's NURIDE.com/RIPTA.
Well, Georgetown lighting it up from three-point range. They're 4-for-6 from beyond the arc right now and 2-of-8 from inside the arc. Been the Chris Dunn show so far for the Friars, keeping the Friars in the game. He's 1-for-2 from the floor. 2-for-4 from the foul line, but he has 5 points, 4 assists, and 3 steals in the ballgame in just 8 minutes. The Friars are down by 3, but he's the guy keeping them in the game. And DeRozier. DeRozier's done a good job in there of fogging up the middle and making the big guy Smith work. But you have Mikel Hopkins and Rivera, Smith Rivera, with 2 fouls each.
Do you feel like the 3-point shooting, 4-for-6? Is a little fool's goal for Georgetown. They only average making 5.5 per game.
Yeah, 35% they shoot. That's not bad. I mean, anything above 33 is like 50% from two-point range. So they're not outstanding, but they're not bad either. But, I mean, I don't think they can stay at that 4-for-6 clip, though.
Friars have the ball. Kyron Cartwright has checked into the game, and there's a kick by Georgetown on the inbounds as Smith Rivera has reentered. Dunn is getting his first breather on the bench. As we said, Cartwright is in for the first time here at the 11:40 mark of the first half. So Hinton will inbound in front of the scoring table on the far side again as the Friars break to the ball, and they find Cartwright on the right sideline, and he clears everybody away, and he'll go freshman on freshman with Trey Campbell. Man-to-man defense is the way Georgetown plays it. And Cartwright, having a hard time with Campbell, stops and has the ball knocked away and stolen. Here's Aaron Bowen driving on Cartwright, scoops it up, missed it on a reverse layup, but a foul was called on Cartwright.
Good foul by Cartwright. Tough turnover right there on him. As a point guard, you got to keep your guy away from you so you don't get a 5-second count, but your teammates need to keep moving so you have an open pass to throw to somebody. And what happens sometimes when you come in the game cold like that, and the defense gets after and overplays all the passing, and Cartwright has to look to maybe take that to the basket and score, and that'll relieve some of the pressure off him that Campbell puts on him. Campbell's been in the game a while, hit 2 3-pointers, leads in the flow. Cartwright comes in cold. That's a tough position.
Dunn right back into the game for Harris as Bowen hits the first free throw. 6'6 senior from Jacksonville,
6.2 points per game off the bench and only a 51% free throw shooter on the season. Second shot as he sets, high arcing shot is good. He got them both. And Georgetown stretches the lead back to 5 at 19-14 after the Friars had tied it up at 14. We've got 11-18 to go in the first half. Dunn has it. Mid-four circle, working on Campbell to the left, gets down the lane, scoops it up with the left hand and scores. Dipsy Doo right down the lane for Dunn.
Dunn's out here in his own personal playground. There's nobody out there that can guard him.
He's got 7 to lead the Friars. On the left wing, Paul White has checked in the game. 6'8 freshman from Chicago. Now for Bowen, right at the top of the key. Mikhail Hopkins on the high post, hands off for Smith Rivera. He brings it around the arc to the right side. Stops, passes on to the wing again for Bowen. Bowen turns and looks at the Friars zone. Campbell touches out to Hopkins. Hopkins, couple of dribbles to the foul line. Stops, looks, turns, 8 to shoot on the right wing for Bowen. Pushes it left for Smith Rivera. He'll drive down to the baseline. Lindsay's all over him with 2, with 1, fade away, hits the front rim, no good. Dunn with the rebound, throws it up the floor for Hinton. Crosses over with a cross step, drives, gets fouled on his way to the hoop, and LaDante will go to the line to shoot 2 free throws. The foul is called inside on White.
Georgetown wants to travel on that one. Good move by LaDante. I thought the foul was right before the shot, but he gets to go to the line for 2. But Dunn gets the rebound, looking up, always has his head up, finds LaDante at the end of the break. So you don't want to set off against that half-court defense every time down.
So LaDante to the foul line, and the free throw is in and out, no good. On the season, 76% for the line. He hasn't scored yet tonight here with 10:29 to go in the half. And the Friars having some trouble with the free throws.
7.
Second shot is good, so he gets his first point. Friars 4-for-8 from the foul line, but back within 2 with 10:25 to go in the half.
Friars is 5-for-8 from the floor.
Up high now, Hopkins gives it out to Smith Rivera, comes off the screen, and he runs right down the lane and lays it up and in.
Well, good move by Rivera. He faked the pass to the corner. The defense went over there.
And Dunn loses the dribble in the backcourt, but gets his balance spinning into the forecourt against Campbell, and Campbell is going to reach in and foul Dunn as he blows right by him. Fans don't like it, but he definitely made contact.
Well, Campbell's been reaching in on that crossover dribble, almost got the turnover on Dunn, but then he hustled back to try to get in front of Dunn and then try to go for the steal again, picked up the foul, 1-1 for Chris Dunn.
That is the 7th team foul for Georgetown with 10:08 to go. First on Campbell, and Dunn will go to line to shoot the 1-1. So Chris, 2-of-4 from the foul line here in the ballgame, made his first 2, missed his last 2. And the first shot here is up, bounces, and comes out.
Boy, oh boy.
Boy, the free throws are going to be another battle again tonight.
4-for-9
on the road.
The 1-1.
You just can't do this on the road and hope to stay in a basketball game. I've never understood it. There's got to be better concentration. Down on the post for Hopkins. Bounce pass down on the left side for Campbell. Campbell to the top of the key, comes right wing for Smith Rivera. Back to Campbell on the left side. Feeds the baseline for Hopkins. Hopkins looks middle of the zone. White up with a jumper, scores from 10.
The setup right there to get the ball into the middle against the zone. You know, you missed the free throws, now it's a 6-point game again. The free throws would have it tied.
It would have it tied. Unfortunately, it's not. Here's Hinton off the top of the key left, now feeds at the free throw line for DeRozier. Backs it out against Hopkins. On the right wing for Dunn in front of the Georgetown bench, up high for Cartwright. And coming off the screen, Hinton is fouled by Bowen.
Georgetown very aggressive on the defense, but picking up silly fouls. Smith Rivera picked up one of those. And right there is another one to send LaDante Hinton to the foul line, but that's the bad news for Georgetown. The good news, Friars can't make free throws at this point. They got to start knocking them down.
Cartwright comes out of the game. Bentel is back in, so a 1-1 for LaDante, who's just made 1-of-2. And the free throw is up, and it's well short, but Bentel gets the offensive rebound, throws up the follow, and it's a brick.
And why do guys get offensive rebounds and feel like they have to shoot it if they get offensive rebound? They have 2 guys on them. Throw it out.
White, top of the key, goes left wing for Bowen. Bowen in front of the Friar bench. Now Smith Rivera up high. There's a 29-footer. Bang.
Well, Rivera says, hey, Dunn's making me look bad. I'm preseason.
I mean, that's way outside.
That was an NBA three-pointer right there.
8 points for Smith Rivera, and the Hoyas are up by 9, and the Friars have gone stone cold and can't make a free throw. Dunn, foul line, drives right, throws up the runner, off the glass, no. Bentel tip, no. Hopkins has it. It's out of bounds, and it is off of Providence and DeRozier. Georgetown will have the ball. 7 unanswered points by the Hoyas, and the Friars have had plenty of chances, just not connected.
Well, the defense has to step up here. They haven't been playing very good D.
Here's Bowen in the lane, almost loses the ball, gets it back to Campbell, steps to the right, fires another three. He misses that one, and the Friars' bench will get the rebound, and it gets knocked out of bounds. It'll be Providence ball. They're going to call a foul, and they're going to call it on White.
Yeah, that's a foul. But Pat Driscoll thinks it's not a foul. He looked right at it. Called a foul on that play.
The off official, Paul Zell, calls the foul on
Paul
White.
It was a foul. He came in and karate chopped him on that play.
That's team foul nine. So a 1-1 the other end. It'll be Ben Bentle.
Now this is the third opportunity for a 1-1. The Friars have missed two of them front ends of 1-1. Left 4 points out there on the foul line. Now they have a third opportunity here.
Bentle on the season, a 59% free throw shooter. Has not scored yet tonight. 4.7 points per game. And the free throw is good. He's got another one coming. So his first point tonight at 7 points and five rebounds in the win over Georgetown on January the 10th at the dunk. Finally, somebody hits a free throw here tonight for the Friars. Second shot for Ben. One dribble at the line. Sets, fires, gets it.
Good hoop. Good two free throws there. Friars needed some points. I mean, they've been
badly
battling, getting to the basket, getting on the line.
Stops a 7-0 Georgetown run. Pulls Providence back within seven with 8.5 to go in the half. High post for Hopkins. Comes left for Campbell. Campbell stops, looks at Chris Dunn. Goes left corner for White. Feeds the post to Hopkins. Tipped away by DeRozier. Picked up by Dunn again. Friars getting their hands in the passing lanes. Dunn, right side, Lindsay. Deep three, good for Jalen Lindsay.
Well, Dunn again with his head up. He was looking for Lindsay all the time. Saw him ahead of the break, nothing there. Lindsay fanned out to the three-point line, and Dunn throws a nice pass to him. He knocks it down.
Lindsay's three-point average has shriveled down to 30% of the season, but he hit a big three right there for his confidence. Here's Rivera to the right side, stops, gives it off to Bowen on the right wing, up high for Hopkins. Back again to Bowen on the right flat. Takes the dribble with the left hand to the center. On the right wing, back to Smith Rivera. Drives around Lindsay. Gets into the lane, and there's a reach-in foul called on the Friars. Lindsay thought he had a steal, but it will be Harris, who comes over on help defense, called for the foul. So a second foul on Tyler Harris in the ballgame. That's team foul five on the Friars, and we have a timeout, 7:47. To play in the first half, it's Georgetown, 26. Providence 22 from Learfield Sports. This is Providence Friar Basketball.
The word to cpromos.com. That's c2cpromos.com.
You're listening to Providence College Basketball with John Rooke and Joe Hassett. Sports Radio 103.7 WEEI.
Get back to the game with Orthopedic Associates, the official orthopedic practice of Providence College Athletics, offering emergency doctor appointments every day. Call 401-944-3800 or visit orthori.com today.
Well, Friars only down four, but they're shooting better from the floor. 7-for-13, they out from the foul line, 6-for-12.
Inbounds coming from the baseline from Peak. He's back into the game. Joshua Smith has also checked back in with Isaac Copeland. And Peak now goes Copeland, left side for Smith Rivera, into the left corner from Aaron Bowen. Harris is on defense on that side of the zone. In the middle for Smith, back out to Smith Rivera, who had no conscience, shooting from almost 30 feet already here tonight. He rolls off a screen, thought about the shot again. Bowen to the top of the key, right side for Peak with 12 to shoot. Baseline right, White jumper from 10 is good. Check that, Copeland from 10 is good.
Well, Copeland has a nice stroke in there. Both he and White have a nice jumper on that mid-range side.
First basket for Isaac Copeland, the freshman from Raleigh, North Carolina. And the Hoyas are back up by 6. Up high, Ben Bentle. Catch and shoot three is no good. My goodness, he's right.
You don't want that one right away.
Peak with the rebound up the floor to Smith Rivera. Smith Rivera on the right wing for Bowen. They feed Smith in the post. DeRozier playing behind him. Smith goes around with the left hand up over his head, rattles the rim, comes out, and Bentle with a rebound. Now for Dunn into the forecourt, up toward the right sideline, comes off the screen, works to the left, wraparound pass for DeRozier. He looks into the lane, turn around, goes up on Smith, and got bumped, throws the ball up at the rim, and throws up an air ball. Did not get a foul call at all on Josh Smith. Copeland drives right, wraparound, scores, and he's fouled by Lindsay.
You know, DeRozier gets hammered on the other end by Smith. Pat Driscoll, I don't know what he's looking at. And then they call that ticky-tack foul down this end. That's a four-point swing right there.
Huge swing.
I mean, DeRozier ended up out of bounds.
He ran into a 350-pound brick wall. And he comes out of the game. Pascal Chukwu comes in. Junior Lumumba also back in. And Copeland will try for the three-point play, an 81% foul shooter on the season. And the free throw is up. Bounces, no good. Bentle with a rebound. Friar deficit is 8. 30-22, 6.5 to play in the first half. Dunn has it on the right wing, up high for Lumumba. Turns, one dribble to the left side, onto the wing for Bentel, looks to the post, not there. Dunn comes off the screen, looks left, lobs back to the right side for Junior. Junior has dribbles back to the center against Smith Rivera. Now Hinton on the right side. Pete Chukwu goes up, got the shot blocked, stopped from behind, out of bounds, and it's going to be Providence ball with 11 to shoot.
Good defense by Georgetown right there, getting in on Chukwu. Chukwu had it up high. They just went up there and got it. Smith's doing a nice job on the back of that defense.
That was a strength issue. Inbounds to Hinton, who drives inside, got the shot knocked out of bounds again by Georgetown on the drive. Hinton's like, I got contact. Where's the foul? But he did not get the call. 9 on the shot clock, and again, the Friars will inbound baseline left of the basket.
Smith is just too good back there. He just beats you up, and then he gets the ball back.
Dunn looks for the inbounds, finds Bentel, goes up strong, and scores off the glass.
Boy, you got to have your lunch pail to get anything inside. Smith is just, he's 380 pounds. I mean, that guy's a moose. You got to get over above him. Nice job by Bentel.
Smith Rivera, top of the key. Zone extends out. Bowen, right corner. Peak, catch and shoot three. No good. Rebound tapped off the glass. Smith is there. Almost stolen by Dunn. It goes out of bounds. It is off of Dunn, and Georgetown will keep it.
Dunn coming in from the top there to try to help out on rebounding.
Again. Well, Dunn does lead the Friars in rebounding at better than 6 boards per game, Joe.
So Smith is the guy that was in foul trouble at Providence, so he's really making his presence felt.
Inbounds to Bowen on a fresh shot clock for the Hoyas. Back outside for Smith Rivera. And he goes back to Bowen on the left side in front of the Friar bench. Finds Copeland in the middle. Jumper is up. Good.
Right. Good pass, too. Copeland comes right in that foul line. Chukwu got a hand up on it, but he makes a nice shot.
That's 6 points for Isaac Copeland, which is about what he averages per game. So the freshman coming up big for Georgetown in the first half here. They're back up by 8. Dunn feeds Bentel, gets knocked away, picked up by Hinton in the post. And then there's travel called on LaDante. He tried to spin out of a double team.
LaDante's had a tough couple of games.
He really has. He had a tough game against DePaul, tougher on Saturday against St. John's, and he's got 1 point tonight.
Well, he's pressing out there. He's 0 for 3. He's just pressing out there and trying to, he has to score 20 points a game. Just let it go, let it flow.
Peak finds the middle for Hopkins. Hopkins has the ball knocked away by Dunn and stolen by Bentel. Dunn pushes up the right side for Lumumba, who attacks, gets cut off. Chukwu at the foul line goes left for Hinton, who drives left, gets the shot blocked. Bentel comes down with the ball, goes
nice.
Back up, scores on the follow, and Ben will go to the line for the three-point play.
And Bentel is a man in there right now. He scored the last time down with a nice big rebound, and that one there, he gets it in traffic and takes it up strong off the glass.
L.J. Peak picks up his second foul for Georgetown. So you got Smith Rivera, Peak, Trawick, and White, each with 2 fouls for Georgetown in the first half.
How about Big Ben? 6 points and 6 rebounds so far here in the first half with 4:55 to go.
And Bentel with a chance at the 3-point play of the foul line on the way. Off the back of the iron, no good, and foul over the back called on the Friars. It's on Chukwu. So Pascal picks up his second. And that's team foul 7 on Providence with 4:55 to go. And Georgetown will now move into the 1-1 bonus and put Isaac Copeland at the foul line to our right.
I like the aggressiveness, though, from Chukwu. He was in there trying to get the rebound, knocking people out of the way off the missed free throw.
So Copeland, who just missed one, 81% from the line, the free throw here is good. He's got 7 first-half points. Coming off of the bench tonight, 6'9 freshman from Raleigh, North Carolina, who only averages about 6 points per game. He did not score against the Friars in the loss in January at the dunk, and he rattles home the second one. 8 first-half points for Copeland, and Georgetown now back up by 8 at 34-26, 4:50 to play before the half. Up high with the ball is DeRozier, leaves it for Bentel inside the top of the key. Ben guarded there by Copeland. Freshman against freshman, now shares it with DeRozier. Step back 17-footer, bounces and stays for Carson.
Carson has a nice touch now from the foul line extended. If he's open, he's in a rhythm, he'll knock it down.
He's got 4 points in the half. Friars are back within 6. Need to play better defense, though. The defense has not been solid enough tonight. On the right wing for Bowen. Bowen at the elbow, right corner. Fake 3 by Peak. Back out for Bowen. Up high again for Smith Rivera. Smith Rivera looks to the middle. Now back to Peak. Back to Smith Rivera. Goes left wing for Bowen. Bowen brings one dribble back out to Smith Rivera. Ooh. He thought about that deep three. Again, Bowen on the left wing with eight to shoot. Bowen in front of the Friar bench. Just Copeland, turnaround, 16-footer, no good. Hent with the offside rebound.
Well, yes, a good defense. Friar's got it right there in the zone.
Here's Dunn, leaves it off for Hent. Catch and shoot for three. Way off the mark, and the rebound for Bowen.
That's just not a good shot. I mean, that's a bad shot. That's not LaDante's game. He's coming down thinking he's like a shooter from out there. That's not his game.
Peek with the ball on the right side against the Friars zone. Feeds the middle again for Copeland. Back to Peek on the wing. Out front for Smith Rivera. Thought about the deep three. Penetrates. Goes left wing. Bowen. He fires off the three. That's too strong. Ball pops out to Bentel. Hands off to Dunn. Friars have a three on three. Dunn down the middle of the lane. Throws it up. And an offensive foul called on Chris.
But Pat Driscoll's an awful official. He stinks tonight. I mean, every call has been against the Friars. He's missed one down the other end. I mean, that's just a bad call. Dunn jumps sideways on that play, and he bails out Rivera standing there.
Second foul on Dunn, and we get a timeout with 3:30 to play in the half, and Georgetown leads by six. From Learfield Sports, this is Providence Friar Basketball.
Now back to Providence College Basketball on Sports Radio 103.7 WEEI.
Contour from Cox is TV just for me, giving you the power to be the master of your TV viewing experience. Check it out, cox.com/contour.
Well, La Jolla is shooting the ball pretty well from three-point range, 5 for 7, just 7 for 19 from inside the arc. Dunn playing good basketball, 6 points, 7 rebounds, 4 steals, and one. Oh, I'm sorry, yeah, 7 rebounds, but doing a good job. Dunn everywhere. He's in the passing lane. Friars can't get a break, though, from Pat Driscoll. I mean, every call has been against Providence, his last 4 calls. Game's very physical, which is fine, but there's no way you can guess right and get in front of Chris Dunn on a fast break when he's coming at you. And he just bailed out Smith Rivera right there, giving him an offensive foul against Dunn. Dunn had him beat.
So Harris, Dunn, and Chukwu have 2 fouls for the Friars. I mentioned Smith Rivera, Peek, Trowick, and White have 2 each for the Hoyas. Hoyas with the basketball, leading by 6, 34-28. 3:25 to go before halftime. Copeland feeds the middle. DeRozier knocks it away. Steals the ball and gives it to Dunn. Up the floor. Dunn pushes Hinton, drives left, and gets fouled by
Peek. Time.
And LaDante will go to the line to shoot two.
Well, Dante's been begging for a foul. Every time he goes to the basket, he's getting hit. And no foul. He asked the officials a few times. He's been getting hit on the wrist. That's his game now, John. Don't settle for a three-point shot coming on the break there. Go to the basket. Create some contact. Get yourself on the line.
And Peek picks up his 3rd personal foul as Hinton at the foul line swishes the first one, just his 2nd point of the first half.
Especially, John, when you're not shooting the ball very well, he's in kind of a slump. You get to the foul line, you knock some free throws down, you get your confidence in your shot.
And that's what he just does, is he knocks down 2.
And then all of a sudden your game comes to you.
And the Friars are back within 4. 3:15 to go on the wing for Copeland. Peek with 3 fouls still in there right now. White goes left. Smith Rivera, open jumper, can't hit it, left wing, rebound tapped and saved by Bentel, and he gets pushed by Smith out of bounds.
Ben Bentel doing a great job on the boards. That's his 7th rebound here in the first half. He got up higher than Smith on that one. Well, Smith's not a great leaper, but he just takes up so much space that you have to get up above him to get the rebound, and Bentel has some good strength. He looks small. I mean, where else see Bentel at the dunk, and he's a big dude.
He's going to get.
He looks small compared to Smith.
He's going to get 2 free throws here, as that's the 10th team foul for Georgetown. So 2 shots the other way. First personal on Josh Smith in the ball game. But Bentel, 2 of 3 from the foul line, has 6 first-half points for the Friars. Already above his average, hits the first free throw. So now those are starting to drop a little bit. As you have
to get a little closer.
Reggie Cameron enters for the first time for Georgetown. Trey Campbell is also back into the ballgame.
Talked to Ben a little bit in the elevator today and said to him, you're playing good basketball, you're rebounding very well, you're not taking those crazy threes. And he laughed. He's taking one in this ballgame, but when he plays smart and goes into the bat, you know, gets some rebounds, shoots the shots in the paint, he's very effective.
Gets ball to the free throws, and the Friars are within 2 as we dip under 3 minutes to play in the half. With the ball, Campbell off the top of the key to the right wing for Copeland and the right corner for White. Against the Friars zone, lobs it back out front, Copeland. Now Campbell looks left again for Cameron. Underneath for Smith, double team. Back again for Cameron on the left side. Campbell pushes right for White, 10 to shoot. Baseline right for Copeland. Copeland looks to the middle, nothing there. Holds on to the ball, throws it out, almost stolen. Campbell picks it up, goes left wide. Cameron for 3, wide open, missed the shot. Hinton with the offside rebound. Friars can tie or take the lead with a basket on this possession. Dunn crosses over to the top of the key, slides to the left. Now cuts back to the right, cuts back to the left again off of DeRozier. Beats Bentel in the post. Bentel, jump hook, score!
Ben doing a great job. Nice job by Dunn, too, probing the defense, finding the open man on the post. He points over to Ben. A good play on that jump hook.
10 points for Bentel in the first half. Friars on an 8-0 run, and they've tied the score at 34. We have an even 2 minutes to play before halftime. Cameron comes right wing again for White. Copeland on the baseline. High arcing jumper is short. There's a rebound tap by Smith, and the Friars take the ball away. No, it's loose. Picked up again. Now Dunn comes out of there with the ball. Dunn up the right sideline, a 2-on-2. Dunn spins right side, hangs, puts it up, won't get it, but gets fouled. On his way to the basket, he's fouled by Campbell, and Dunn will have a chance to give the Friars the lead at the foul line.
Say what, Dunn is a nightmare when he's coming at you at a full head of speed. Campbell, not a slow guy. He has no chance against Dunn coming on him. He might have to guess to take an offensive foul, but Dunn was moving so quickly. He just created the contact, gets to the line, and makes the first free throw.
And Chris has now hit 3 of 6 from the free throw line, so off the average of 67% of the season, but he's given Providence their first lead of the ball game with 1:44 to play before the half. Second shot by Dunn. Rattles and comes out. And the rebound for Copeland, but a one-point Providence lead. Shoot, if they did some free throws tonight, Joe, they'd be up double digits right now. With the ball, Campbell to the right side for Copeland. Looks it down low. Has the ball way outside against the Friars zone, which extends out on him. White comes left for Campbell again. Now back to White at the top of the key. Feeding underneath for Smith. Wraps around, puts it up, and scores.
He got it in too close right there. Once he gets it that close, he just can't get around him.
That's his first field goal of the game for Josh Smith. And he gives the Hoyas the one-point lead at 36-35. We got 1:11 to go before halftime. Friars still with the basketball as Dunn bounces high post for DeRozier. Carson now shares it with Bentel just inside the top of the key. Comes back to Junior at the foul line. Goes down the lane, lies it up, and puts it up too strong off the front of the rim. Georgetown with the ball up the floor for Campbell. Campbell drives right side, blocked by Henton. But Copeland's right there to put it home.
Good block there by Henton, but nobody got back on defense.
10 points for Copeland for Georgetown in the half. And the Hoyas back up by 3. 42 seconds to go before half. And Dunn walks it right to left into the forecourt.
Lumumba got killed when he went to the basket.
Yeah, Cooley's pleading the case. Dunn drives Henton, wide open three. Yes, from the left corner.
That's when he gets those shots, when he's wide open, John. Gets his feet set, nobody around him. When he catches the ball on the move to take a three-point shot, he doesn't make them. But right there, when his feet are set, stationary, knocks them down.
And John Thompson calls a 30-second timeout with 28.2 left on the clock. And it's 38-38 as the Friars have tied it up again after the Hoyas have taken a lead.
Good basketball by the Friars. Halftime cannot come fast enough, I think, for the Friars. They're playing good basketball, but I think they're a little winded out there. They battled down 8 points in this ballgame, kept battling and battling to get back in it. Georgetown has some good looks to extend the lead. Friars missed some free throws. Look a little tired out there for that last minute and a half stretch here. So they get this thing tied at halftime. They'll take it because Georgetown's played pretty good basketball. Shot the ball extremely well from three-point range. The Friars are able to stay in this one and have it tied right now with 28 seconds to go in the half.
Well, one thing's for sure, there will be a big stat that'll have to give tonight. Both teams are undefeated on the season, Joe, when they lead at halftime.
I suppose there's a tie.
Well, that
could very well be.
But that means they're not leading, right?
Absolutely. It could be a tie in this one.
Georgetown has the ball. 28 seconds to go before the half. We're tied at 38. Friars sit back to our right in the 2-3, but Lumumba now extends out on Smith-Rivera, and he's just inside the mid-floor line, going to run some clock down. So he's dribbling the ball out near the mid-floor line, down to 15 seconds. Now makes his move left wing. Campbell.
Smith-Rivera.
Comes right side Copeland. Back to Campbell again. Left side for White with 9 seconds. Campbell comes to Copeland. Right corner now for Smith-Rivera. He's going to go up for the deep three. Bang.
Ray LaDante's mug right there. Knocked it down. You know he's going to take that shot.
And it's time.
Oh, boy.
Time runs out on the first half, and Smith-Rivera catch and shoot Trey. He hit 3 threes in the first half, 11 points for the Hoyas, and they take a 41-38 lead into the locker room at halftime. Our Health Source RI halftime report coming up from Learfield Sports. This is Providence Friar Basketball.
Yes. But with Dunkin's Mocha Swirl Iced Coffees and new chocolate croissants, it's become an obsession.
With that much chocolatey deliciousness, obsession is quite natural.
Calling all chocolate lovers, get your afternoon chocolate fix with Dunkin' Donuts Mocha Swirl Coffees and Lattes or a deliciously sweet new chocolate croissant. America runs on Dunkin'. Price participation may vary. Limited time offer.
This is my contour, and it reshapes TV completely around me. Its amazing new app knows exactly what
I like and recommends new shows and movies I love.
Contour's guide puts my personal favorites
front and center, so I search less and discover more. With Contour, my perfect show is always just a
swipe away, and I can watch on my tablet or my TV,
whether it's on right now, on demand,
or in my library. Contour's DVR can record 6 shows at once and store
1,000. So I always have my own personal
favorites to watch whenever, however I want.
This isn't TV for everyone. Contour's TV.
Me. Introducing Contour, only from Cox. Discover your Contour at cox.com/contour. Available to residential customers with Cox Advanced TV Preferred and Internet Preferred. Digital receiver / remote and Cox approved modem required. DVR storage based on 1,000 hours of SD recordings. Capacity may vary with mix of HD and SD programming. Other conditions may apply.
In 1933, our grandfather, Tom Hackson, started out selling beer and wine in a small liquor store in Oneyville, Rhode Island. And in 1962, our father, Jack Hackson, moved Hackson to his present location on Route 2 in Warwick to provide our customers with the best selection and the lowest prices.
And after 3 family generations, we've made Hackson's Liquors one of the largest liquor stores in New England, which means that we buy the most, so you pay the least.
Visit the newly remodeled Hackson Superstore on Bald Hill Road in Warwick,
where we buy the most, so you pay the least.
This is your home for PC Fryer basketball. Sports Radio 103.7 WEEI.
John and Joe back at the Verizon Center in Washington, D.C., 41-38. Hoyas at the break in the Big East tonight. Villanova held home floor. They beat Marquette 70-52. Creighton leads at the half at Xavier, 32-29. Xavier hasn't lost at home yet this year, and that's where the Friars go on Saturday.
Yeah, that's a tough place to play. And, you know, this league is crazy. You know, you take Creighton, they've been in a lot of close games. They've lost 3 or 4 games at the last possession, so they very easily could be in there 4 or 5 wins.
Friars in the road black, Georgetown in the home gray. Providence will have the basketball to start the second half, and they'll go basket to our right here in half number 2. Original 5 of Bentel, Dunn, DeRozier, Lamumba, Henton. For Georgetown, Isaac Copeland and Trey Campbell, 2 freshmen who came off the bench the first half, will start the second half, along with Josh Smith, and Jabril Trawick. He's back in and picked up 2 early fouls and sat out much of the first half. Friars open up, and we're underway here in half number 2, with Providence down by 3 at the break. Dunn has it on the left side, comes off the Bentel screen right, bounce pass underneath. DeRozier has the ball knocked out of his hands, and Smith comes up with it.
Well, I mean, it was a good pass, too. DeRozier got to take that up strong and create some contact against Smith.
Georgetown basket to our left here in half number 2. Friars come out and extend the 2-3 zone. Smith Rivera off the top, out between the circles, has the dribble right. Now feeds to Trawick up high, feeds the high post, Copeland down low, Smith, and he dunks it.
A little miscommunication right there. Smith was wide open on that one. As DeRozier went up to the foul line, there's nobody behind him.
And it's just Smith's second basket of the ball game, but Georgetown now back up by 5. They led by as much as 9 in the first half. Friars had a one-point lead, a wraparound pass from Dunn to DeRozier, who lays it up and scores from the right side.
What a great pass by Dunn in traffic.
And that's 9 assists in the ball game for Chris Dunn, who also had 8 points in the first half.
We want a good start here in the second half. You don't want to fall down by 8 points again to this club.
Here's Copeland in the middle. 3 black shirts around him on the right wing. Trawick, jump pass left side for Campbell. Kept by Lumumba, but picked up by Smith on the baseline. Back out for Campbell. Georgetown saves an almost steal there. Smith Rivera feeds the post to Smith. Inside, bounces back out for Smith Rivera with 8 to shoot. Backs it outside. From the right side, going to go up for a deep 25-footer. Missed that one, and the rebound followed. No good, and Henton finally clears it. Up the floor, Friars on the break, done. Leaves it off for Henton, and the ball gets knocked back away and stolen. And a 4-on-1 break. Left wing, Smith Rivera pulls up for 3. Missed it, and DeRozier rebounds.
That's the new basketball, 3-on-1, and you stop to take a 3-pointer. I think Dunn that time, he's trying to force the pass into LaDante, trying to get him going. He wasn't open on that play. Fortunately for the Friars, they don't give up any points.
Dunn on the right wing with the ball. Gives the ball back over to DeRozier on the right side. Now finds Henton at the foul line. Left wing Lumumba feeds Bentel in the post. Backs his way in on Copeland. Tries to go up with a jump hook and a reach-in foul. Is called on Georgetown, and it will be on Josh Smith, his second personal.
Boy, Ben Bentel is really maturing as a play. He's gotten better and better each game. You know, see how patient he is right now. He gets the ball in the post. He looks around, and nobody's open. Takes it strong inside. He has a size and strength advantage inside. He goes in, creates the contact, gets himself up to the line.
So Ben has two shots at the foul line, and the first one here is good. So Bentel has hit 5 of 6 from the free throw line in the ballgame and has 11 points. That's
making me look good, too. Kevin Greavy's here from the Lakers, who plays play against when he's with the Bullets, the Washington Wizards now. And he asked me about the players, and, you know, he's here to see him and Dunn. I said, well, watch his kid, Bentel. I said, he's going to be something special by the time he's a senior. Well, he's doing a pretty good job here as a freshman.
He gets them both. He's got 12, and it's 43-42. Georgetown's lead cut to 1. Trowick has it up high, gives it left outside the arc to Copeland. Copeland on the left sideline for Smith Rivera. Back to Copeland. Right side Trowick. Hands off for Campbell in front of his bench. Feeds Smith. Down low underneath. Gives it back to Smith. It gets fouled from behind. He'll have to earn it at the foul line. Foul inside is called on whom?
Dunn went up to try to block the shot.
And that's 3 fouls on Chris Dunn with 17:37 to play.
You know, he had to come down. He came down from the top of the key to help out on defense. Smith caught the ball in the middle, hits the post, and then he rolls to the basket. Did the pass and roll there by the big fella.
Smith's free throw is in and out. No good. He is just 1 of 3 from the foul line. Has 5 points in the night. Averages 12 per game. 7 in the league in rebounding. Transfer from UCLA. Had a 15-point, 12-rebound double-double in the loss to the Friars in January. Second shot. No good. And there's Lumumba with a rebound. And the Friars can take a lead on this possession.
I like Lumumba in the game. He's solid out there defensively. Makes good, solid plays.
And here's Lumumba with the ball on the right wing against Georgetown's man. He passes to DeRozier, who gets pushed out of the post by Smith. Gives it to LaDante in the right corner. Gives the ball back out now for DeRozier on the right side. Out for Dunn, and the Friars set it up again. Dunn goes left off of DeRozier's screen, curls around down the lane, scoops it up with the right hand. Score!
Oh, man.
And the Friars lead.
I mean, he is doing a job on that pick and roll. Like, he's like an NBA player out there playing against his team.
10 for Dunn. Friars lead 44-43. We're 3 minutes deep into the second half. Top of the key, Smith Rivera. Campbell on the right side in front of his bench. Back to Smith Rivera between the circles. Now goes back to Campbell. Back to Smith Rivera. Comes left wing for Copeland against the Friars zone. Smith Rivera fakes the deep three. Campbell on the wing. Down to 11 to shoot. Copeland comes out center. Grabs it left side for Trowick. Fakes. Drives inside. Leans in. Scoots it through. There's Campbell with 4 to shoot. Gets down the lane. Lays it up. Scores.
Wow. What a nice play by Campbell. That's a tough shot. The defense wasn't bad right there. He had to take it against the defense. As the shot clock was winding down, he squeezes one off.
It was very good defense, but Campbell now with 8 points in the ballgame gives Georgetown the 1-point lead again. And Dunn brings it left to right into the fourth court, and Georgetown goes 2-3 zone for the first time in the ballgame. Dunn.
They can't guard Dunn.
They feed him back out to Dunn, fakes, drives, strips, stolen from behind. Flip pass into the fourth court. Campbell chases it down and lays it in.
Well, Campbell's starting this half because he did a good job defensively against Dunn in the first half. Nobody can guard him, but Campbell bothered him a little bit. That time there, he deflected the pass and got out on the break.
And Campbell has 10 points. He only averages 2.9 per game. Georgetown up by 3. Dunn works right off the Georgetown 2-3 zone. I'm going to wave everybody through. He goes left side on the wing now for Lumumba. Feeds DeRozier at the foul line. And there's a whistle, and an offensive foul is called in the paint. And I believe it's on Bentel.
Yep. Bentel trying to get position right there.
That's his first foul, second on the team. And we have a timeout, 15:41 to play in the ballgame. Friars grab a lead, but give it right back up again. Georgetown by 3 from Learfield Sports. This is Providence Friar basketball. John and Joe, Verizon Center in Washington. 47-44, Georgetown the lead here with 15:41 to play here in the second half. Hoyas 10-2 at home this year, 4-1 in Big East play. They've won 5 of their last 6 overall since losing to Providence a month ago at the Duncan overtime.
Well, they're playing good basketball, and Friars are 2 right now, but the turnovers hurting the Friars in the second half. Friars have 3 turnovers already here in the second half, and Georgetown doesn't have any. Friars are 2 for 3. When they do have the ball, they're shooting the ball fine. Georgetown taking advantage of those turnovers by the Friars, 4 for 7, and have extended their little lead here to 3 points, but you know, you had the Friars up by 1. If they can get themselves a 5 or 6 point lead in this ball game, that puts more pressure on Georgetown. They've been playing with the lead the whole game. They could get behind, let them get behind a little bit and see what they do.
Yeah, but the Hoyas have the ball with that 3 point lead as they bring it right to left into the forecourt. Trowick comes left to Copeland looking at the Friars zone on the left wing for LJ Peak. Back in the game with 3 fouls. Trowick has it right of the key. Now goes to the sideline. Smith Rivera back to Trowick. Comes left for Peak. peek, looks down the baseline left for Copeland, feeds the middle inside, knocked away. Brown come up with a steal.
Dunn knocked that one away.
Dunn has it in the forecourt. Tyler Harris has checked into the ball game. As Dunn has it left, goes to Harris, back to a 2-3 zone defensively for Georgetown in this possession. Lindsay also into the game for the Friars. Dunn comes off the screen, looks, and feeds inside for Bentle, goes up, had the ball knocked away, but picked up again by Ben on the left side and lobs it back out to Dunn. Lindsay feeds DeRozier at the foul line. Back to Chris. Left wing for Harris. Fakes the tray. Baseline runner up. Off the back iron. No good. Rebound for Peek.
That's a good shot. You got to make that one.
Here's Peek in transition. Right wing Smith Rivera. Thought about that three in front of his bench. Stops in the right corner. Peek drives baseline. Goes up. Elevates. Missed the shot. Tips it out. Alive, though, to Trawick in the left corner. Now Trawick pulls it up. Shot clock did not restart. Down to 16 seconds. Trawick works left. Gets in the lane. Crosses over. Throws it up and gets fouled. DeRozier, I believe, will get him with a foul.
Good move there by Trawick as he got into the paint right there. Dipsy do, and then just created some contact. DeRozier just threw him to the floor.
First foul on Carson, third on the Friars, and he'll put Verbrill Trawick at the foul line for the first time tonight. 3 points in the first half, 64% foul shooter on the season, averaging 8.2 points per game. And Georgetown in the first half was 5 of 9, or actually 5 of 7 on the line, 0 for 2 here in the second half, but he sinks that one.
Well, Trawick didn't get a lot of minutes that first half. Only played, what, 8 minutes because of foul trouble.
Paul White checks in now for Georgetown, replacing Isaac Copeland.
Those two guys are, like, interchangeable. They play the same type of game, both same size. They shoot a little bit.
Second shot for Trawick is up, and that's nothing but net, and so Georgetown stretches that lead with 6 unanswered points, back out to 5 at 49-44, and a timeout is called on the floor. We'll take it as well. 14:26 left. Friars down 5 from Learfield Sports. This is Providence Friar Basketball.
Now back to Friar Basketball on Sports Radio 103.7 WEEI.
You spend your life working, so discover the world as you go. The Renaissance Providence Downtown Hotel.
Well, we got that machine out here shooting jerseys into the crowd. It's pretty cool.
Rapid fire machine gun here. I know.
Well, Friars just 1-for-3 so far here in the second half, John, with 14:26 to go. The Hoyas 3 of 8. Friars with 4 turnovers. The Hoyas with just 1. Both teams with 3 rebounds. But the zone, since the Hoyas have gone to the zone, the Friars haven't scored. So Ed Cooley calls a timeout, trying to get something here where he can get a shot. Good look at the basket. You know, trying to, you know, Chris Dunn going to zone. Bruce Thompson went to zone because they have no answer for Chris Dunn. He's scoring whenever he wants. He's finding the open man, but his zone slows him down. He can't get to the basket against his zone. And that's the way the Friars have been scoring. So someone needs to step up and knock down some jumpers here.
By the way, LaDante Hinton not in the game. Jalen Lindsay is. He has the ball on the left side. Dunn now has it out front against Georgetown zone. Shows the ball left, brings it to the right, looks into the corner. They find DeRozier on the baseline. They run out at him. He drives, and he's fouled on the floor by Mikhail Hopkins.
How about setting up that play for DeRozier for a jump shot? He pump fakes in the corner and goes to the basket. Well, DeRozier's one of the best outside shooters when you look at the stats.
First foul on Hopkins. Second foul on Georgetown. Friars inbound to the baseline. New shot clock as Dunn brings it out to the center. Pushes right for Tyler Harris. Back to Dunn, fakes the three, penetration, left corner. Lindsay for three, off the back iron, won't get it. Rebound, Harris had it, but it's taken by Trawick in the left right corner.
Well, Lindsay again with a wide open look. Good shot.
Left wing for Peek. Now back up front for Trawick. Trawick drives by Dunn down the lane, banks it up, gets it to go, and one.
Well, Trawick, the last two possessions, put his head down and is going to the basket and created contact and gets to the line for 2 free throws, and now he gets that one to go, and now he's going to get a 3-point play opportunity. All of a sudden, it's a 7-point game, could go to 8. That's what the lead has been, seems like, the whole game with Georgetown. Friars get it back to 0 or 1, and boom, Georgetown gets it back up to 8. An 8-point lead against this club feels like 15.
Second foul on DeRozier, and Trawick come alive here a bit in the second half. Has a chance at the 3-point play and can put his team back up by 8. They led by as much as 9 in the first half, but the free throw is no good. Hopkins, offensive rebound for Georgetown on the baseline, took it away.
Get away from Ben Benfield, who's having a good half, too.
White has it. Now Smith Rivera, top of the key, deep three, off the rim, and there's Bentle with a rebound. Wow.
Yeah, that was a escape, that one by Rivera missing.
Here's Dunn quickly into the fourth quarter, the top of the key. Friars trailing by seven. Hinton back in the game. Feeds to Rozier in the post. Now back to Dunn on the left sideline as Hinton had come into the game for Harris.
This is what they really need, Lindsay, to make some shots.
Somebody's got to hit a shot against the zone. Bounce pass to Dunn, right corner. Lindsay gets off a high three. Short. Won't get it. Smith Rivera with a rebound. Got to hit shots. Here is Peak driving right, puts it up, blocked from behind by DeRozier. Friars get the rebound, here comes Dunn in transition. Friars need to push it, here's Hinton, open three, left wing. That is also no good, and another rebound for Hopkins.
Friars have not scored since Georgetown's gone to the zone.
The door has slammed shut. Here's Smith Rivera, top of the key, goes left side for White. Back to Smith Rivera to the right side for Peak. Jab steps up the three-point line. Now White comes up to the top of the key to grab the ball, left for Trawick. He's going to again push his head down the lane, and Bentel reaches in and fouls it. So when he gets ahead of steam, the Friars have no foot movement at all on defense to get over and stop him or slow him down.
Well, he hit a three-pointer the first play of the game, so the Friars are running out at him, and that's what he wants. He wants to go to the basket. He takes a three-pointer just to keep you honest. But he's the guy you want taking threes, really. I mean, he's not a guy who's a very good outside shooter.
That's team foul five, so Georgetown inbounds. It's an 8-0 Hoya run. Smith Rivera has it underneath. Smith jams it.
Well, Chupa came over to help out. Didn't have no help on Smith inside. All of a sudden, it's a 9-point game.
10 unanswered points for the Hoyas, and they've matched their largest lead at 9. 12-22 left.
And it's the zone, John. The zone is just wearing the Friars out. They haven't scored yet.
Here's Dunn driving left. And gives the pass to Hinton in and out of his hands, and White intercepts, lobs the ball to Peak down the floor, lays it up, scores, and he's fouled by Harris. And this has just gotten ugly in a hurry. Tyler Harris with a lazy foul, his third of the ball game, and Georgetown is pouring it up.
Keep saying it, but the zone, the Friars just haven't had any good looks. Well, had good looks against the zone, just aren't making shots. And they're not getting back on defense either.
Peak has a chance at the three-point play, and the shot is good. He's got 5 points in the game. 56-44, the largest lead of the ballgame for Georgetown. Ed Cooley calls a timeout with 12:09 to go. We'll hold on to it here. It's a 30-second timeout, but Georgetown has scored 13 unanswered points after the Friars took a lead.
Well, if you're not hitting the outside shot against the zone, you got to get the ball into the middle and gaps. And then look opposite and get into the gaps and get something going to the basket. Tyler Harris had a nice play to go to the basket, just missed the shot. Lindsay's had two wide open threes, one on each corner, has missed both of those. And the zone really neutralizes Dunn. I know I've said that a couple of times, but Dunn, he hasn't had any looks at shots, and he's trying to penetrate, but he hasn't been able to get any penetration against the zone. They're double-teaming him. And the man-to-man, Dunn was killing Georgetown. They had to go to zone to slow him down, and it's worked. That's why they have the 12-point lead.
Friars have only made one of six shots overall from the floor in the second half, while Georgetown is 6 of 12, so the Friar defense isn't much better than the offense right now. Providence also has 5 turnovers. Hasn't helped the cause. Kyron Cartwright is checked into the game. He penetrates right, finds Hinton in the middle of the zone, who leans in with a left hand, banks it up, and scores.
That's where you got to go. Get it into LaDante on the foul line and let him do some work in there. He's tough in traffic.
That's just his second field goal of the game for Hinton. 8 points, and that stops a 13-0 Georgetown run. And the Friars are back within 10. Top of the key, Peak. They feed the middle. Smith, right wing. Smith, Rivera for three. Got it.
Well, they get the ball in. Smith's a good passer, and they get the ball into him. The Friars collapse the defense, throw it outside to Smith Rivera. He knocks down the three.
First basket of the second half for Smith Rivera. That's his fourth tray of the ball game, and it's a 13-point lead again. Here's Cartwright, right at the top of the key against Peak. We've got 11:19 still to play, but the run is 16-2 right now for the Hoyas. Here's Hinton for three. Hits it from the left side in front of his bench.
That's a big hoop right there. LaDante got a nice basket in the paint. That gets his rhythm going a little bit. Now they got to hit some stops.
11 for Hinton, but you're right. Stops have got to come. Back to a 10-point game. Peak between the circles. Now White on the right side. Finds Smith. Rivera feeds the post to Smith. It's batted around and it's intercepted by Harris under the basket. Now for Dunn in transition. Crosses over down the lane. Goes up and he gets a held ball or a foul. They're going to call
a foul.
And it will be on zero. That's L.J. Peak, his fourth. Just the third team foul for Georgetown in the half, however. And we have an official's timeout. 10:49 remaining. The Friars down 10. From Learfield Sports, this is Providence Friar Basketball. Friar fans, give your vehicle the defense it deserves and switch to GEICO. Providence College alumni can save on GEICO car insurance with a special discount. Visit GEICO.com for a free quote today. Chris Dunn getting ready to go to the foul line, try to pull the Friars back within single-digit deficit here. Still a ton of time at 10:49 to go, but well, the stand has to be made somewhere after giving up a 13-0 run to the Hoyas here in the second half after taking a lead.
Well, the zone has really bothered the Friars. They've only scored 5 points since Georgetown's going into that zone about 7 or 8 minutes ago. And Dunn makes a nice play right there on the fast break. If you can beat the zone down the floor, you get some baskets on the fast break. And that's what the Friars need to do, beat that defense down the floor. The Friars just 4-for-8 from the floor in the second half, 50%. Georgetown 7-for-13 at 54%. Hoyas out rebounding the Friars 7-5.
Dunn has 2 shots at the line, as we said, and the first one is up and good with another one coming. That's his 11th point of the night.
He's had a good ball game, Chris Dunn. He's, you know, a lot of things he does doesn't show up in the stats either. He gets triple doubles, but he controls the game out there, everything he does.
Got them both. He's 5-of-9 from the line now for the ball game, and the Friars are back within 8. Trowick has it in the backcourt. And we'll bring it up for Georgetown. Basket to our left.
Not a good matchup here. It's Harris on Trowick.
It's a man-to-man right now for the Friars. So they've come out of the zone for the first time tonight. Trowick drives right. Cut off by Chukwu. Drives down the lane. Puts it up right side. No good. Rebound Smith underneath. Gets hammered from behind. He's just so hard when he gets that low. And the foul is called on Dunn. Oh, boy. And that is 4 fouls on Chris Dunn with 10:31 to play.
Well, Dunn's in there battling, looking for the rebounds, but Harris got beat off the screen up high, and Trowick, he just wants to go to the basket like a bull in a china shop. He gets in there, he creates the contact, he lowers the shoulder, and defense comes to help out, and that's where Smith is able to move into the open spot. Once he gets in the open spot, forget it. He's going to get the ball and get the basket.
Smith hits the first free throw. He's just 2-of-5 from the foul line, but has 8 points in the ballgame now for the Hoyas. Aaron Bowen comes out. Trey Campbell comes back in for Georgetown. Dunn also comes out of the game. He doesn't have any choice now with 4 fouls, and Junior Lumumba back in with Kyron Cartwright in the backcourt. Not a lot of offense there.
Let's see if Georgetown goes back to man-to-man. The zone has worked so well.
Smith misses the second shot. Hinton gets the rebound. So it's a 9-point game. They've led by as much as 13 here in the second half, but the Friars have also had a lead in the second half. That's all volatile it's been. Cartwright goes left side, catch and shoot, high arcing three. Good! He brought rain on that one for LaDante Hinton.
Well, if you're Georgetown, he'll take that shot all day. I mean, I can't believe he made that shot. The defense was right there. Great shot by LaDante. You say, no, no, no. Oh, good shot.
Yeah, 14 points now for Hinton. Here's Smith again in the post. Kicks the ball out to White. He's got a wide open three. It's no good, and there's a rebound for Hinton. Hands off to Cartwright. Friars trying to get in transition. Cartwright wheels around Smith. Rivera kicks it out to Smith. Harris now drives, goes up, got his shot blocked by White, and then Smith comes down with the ball and gets hammered by Harris. Boy, Tyler Harris is having a rough go of it again. That's his 4th foul. And that is now team foul 8. So a 1-1 the other way for Georgetown, 9:46 left.
I thought Cartwright should have gone to the basket on that play. He had an opening. Go to the basket. I'd rather have him taking the shot, going to the basket in the paint.
Well, put him at the foul line if he draws contact.
Rather than give it back to Harris. I mean, Harris is stuck out there in no man's land and at the shot block.
Harris comes out of the game. As Smith now has the 1-1 at the line for Georgetown, and the free throw is good. Hoyas are 10 of 16 from the free throw line of the ballgame. 9 points for Smith. Second shot is on the way, and he line drives it in. Gets them both. Figures, right? 62-54, back to an 8-point Georgetown lead. 9:43 to play as Cartwright into the forecourt for Lumumba. Bentel is checking the game. Chukwu is also in there. As Cartwright drives, gets cut off by Campbell. Right side for Hinton. Hinton gives it back to Kyron, who circles to the center. Between the circles. Now goes to the left wing again for Lumumba. Georgetown stays in the zone. Cartwright has the ball almost taken away by Campbell, but a jump pass left side of Lumumba, and he gets fouled by White underneath.
It's only the 14th foul for Georgetown.
Third personal on White with 9:22 to go. The Friars will have to inbound it. Here comes Carson DeRozier back into the game for Pascal Chukwu.
Cartwright's got to be careful with the ball out there. He's very quick, but this Campbell has very quick hands. You put the ball in front of him, he gets a finger on it.
Cartwright inbounds to Henton. Now between the circles, the Friars get a fresh shot clock. Trailing by 8. 9:16 to play. Cartwright has it between the circles. 2-3 zone again for Georgetown. Lumumba out center for the ball. One dribble pushes right for LaDante. Henton bounces to Cartwright on the right sideline. Now gets around a DeRozier screen in the middle of the floor. Wide open jumper up and in for Cartwright.
He's got that game. He's got to think about his shot. He thinks about passing all the time. Think of that shot when you get in the paint.
That's his first basket of the game. And Cartwright pulls the Friars back within 6. Manageable deficit if you play defense. White, one dribble toward the left. On the left sideline for Smith Rivera. He's got Cartwright over there. Now back up high for Smith. Smith hands off Smith Rivera. Cuts to the right. Kicks the ball back left wing for White. And a travel for Paul White.
Good job on the closeout there by Bento. White wanted to take that shot, but he missed a shot out there badly last time. So he pumped fake. Shuffled his feet, get into the basket, and he comes out of the game.
10th turnover of the game for the Hoyas. And so the Friars have it, down 6, trying to make headway with Chris Dunn on the bench with 4 fouls.
And Copeland comes in for the Hoyas.
Isaac Copeland is checked in. Here's Cartwright, left side for LaDante, back to Bentel. Now comes right for Lumumba. Hands off to Cartwright on the right wing. Zone extends out on him. Cartwright backs it out between the circles again. Wants somebody to go to the middle. Here's LaDante, drives, loses the ball on the wing. It's picked up by Bentel. Out to Cartwright. DeRozier, open foul line. Kicks the ball out to Junior, who fires a 3. That's no good. And the rebound taken in the middle of the lane by Smith Rivera. He gets bumped. Underhanded pass to Trowick. Stolen by Lumumba. He has it the other way. A 3-on-1. Lumumba drives right, lays it up, scores.
Good job by Lumumba. Faked the pass, and Smith Rivera went for the fake, and Lumumba lays it up nicely.
First basket of the game for Junior, and the Friars are back within 4, and John Thompson, the third, calls a timeout for Georgetown with 7:49 still to play. So the Friars, down by as much as 13, are back within 4, and almost 8 minutes left on the clock.
Well, LaDante Henton has 8 points in the last few possessions. He had 2 3-pointers and a shot off the glass over the big guy Smith. And Cartwright's done a nice job with Dunn on the bench of getting to the basket. Fry's on a 12-3 run. But Cartwright's done a nice job of turning the corner off those screens and allowing the defense to collapse. When they don't collapse, he's taking that little foul line jump shot. He knocked it down. But they're making shots, John. That's the bottom line. You're playing against the zone. You got to make shots if you're open. And Fry's to get back in this one now. They're starting to make some shots.
So the timeout called by John Thompson, the third. Georgetown has 3 timeouts remaining. The Friars have 2 left. Providence has 18 fouls, so the Hoyas are in the bonus already, but only 4 team fouls for Georgetown, so they've got 2 more to give before Providence goes to the free throw line.
Well, the Friars now need to play some defense. They made some good stops here to get themselves back down the other end and get an opportunity to score. Need to stop here.
Georgetown has the ball, an inbound from the near the mid-floor line, far side, into the forecourt to Smith Rivera, back to Trowick in front of his bench. Now up high for Smith. Right wing Smith Rivera, man on man, comes around a screen, gets a 3 and hits it.
Oh, that's a big hoop right there as you set the screen by Smith. I mean, he's so big, there's so much room. If you go underneath that screen, forget it, it's too late.
That's 5 trays for Devontae Smith Rivera, the preseason player of the year in the Big East, and he's playing like that one tonight. Big basket indeed. Here's Henton. Now finds DeRozier at the foul line. Kicks it right wing for Bentel. Baseline. Lumumba jumper up. Good! And fouled! He hit the 15-foot jumper from the right baseline and got sent to the floor by Josh Smith.
Smith got out there late, but they finally call a foul on Smith bumping into somebody. He's been knocking people all over the place. And Lumumba makes the shot and gets to the line.
So we got officials timeout. 7:18 to go. The Friars back within 5 and a chance to close within 4. When we return from Learfield Sports, this is Providence Friar Basketball. There's a new name in luxury. Visit Sidney Thomas Jewelers in Boston and Providence for the world's most beautiful jewels. John Rooke, Joe Hassett at the Verizon Center in Washington, D.C. We've got 7:18 to play. Friars have fallen down by as much as 13 and a half, have had a 1-point lead in the half, and right now it's a 5-point game with Junior Lumumba going to the foul line to try to complete a 3-point play and pull Providence back within 4.
I like what Lumumba did right there, too, John. He had an open look possession and a half ago from the right wing here. Missed the shot, but he caught that one on the baseline. Didn't hesitate. Went up in the air and took it over the big guy, Smith, who came out on him late and hit him. He still made the shot, and he gets to go to the line for a 3-point play. The young guys are playing well, too. You got Bento with 12 points and 9 rebounds in the ballgame, and Chris Dunn has 12 points and 9 assists. Friars are shooting 20 of 38. Good shooting percentage, 53%. Georgetown 23 of 50 have taken 12 more shots than the Friars at 46%, and Georgetown's 8 for 18 from beyond the arc.
Junior's a 69% free throw shooter, but that one spins in and out. And Paul White, correction, Isaac Copeland gets the rebound, so the game stays at 5 as the Hoyas have the basketball. We come up close to the 7-minute mark to play. And the Friars go back to a zone as Copeland has it, top of the key, Campbell right wing for Trowick. Back to Campbell, between the circles. Trowick on the right wing, steps up now to Campbell, top of the key, back to Trowick again on the right edge. Campbell goes left for Smith Rivera, looks inside. Bentel comes out to get him on that side of the zone. 7 to shoot. Copeland to Trowick, tipped away by Lumumba from behind. Friars came up with the ball, and a foul is called on Georgetown.
On Trowick.
It's on Trowick, who picks up his third.
There's that guy Lumumba again. Nice job at the top of the zone. He anticipated the pass, deflected it away into LaDante's hands, and Trowick picks up the foul.
And the 16th foul on the Hoyas. Next one, who puts the Friars at the line, and here comes Mikhail Hopkins back in, replacing Josh Smith at center. The Friars trying to make this run here without Chris Dunn, who's on the bench. He picked up his fourth foul with 10:31 to go, and that was almost 4 minutes ago. Here's Cartwright working into the forecourt. Georgetown back to the 2-3 zone. Lumumba between the circles. Drives left. Left sideline with the ball is Cartwright. Back to Junior at the top of the key. Pulls it out. Again to Kyron on the left side. Looks to the middle. Junior has it at the top. Now comes right wing for Hinton. But Dante back to Junior, gets penetration, throws it up underneath, and he finds Bentel for the lay-in.
Good job by Junior Lumumba again in the middle of that defense. Takes it to the foul line, finds the big fella, gets the layup.
16-6 is the Friar run. They're back within three with 6:10 to go. Peek has it between the circles, comes left side for Trowick. Again, Peek comes to the right wing for Smith Rivera. Back to Peek again up high. Peek goes back. Smith Rivera on the right side. Back to Peek again. Penetrates left. Left corner baseline. Foul.
Stepped out of bounds.
Stepped out of bounds. Trowick turns it over.
Trowick stepped out of bounds on that pass from Peek. And the Friars get the ball back. Trowick says, what are you talking about?
He took a back step as he drove baseline and he hit out of bounds, said official Paul Zelk. 13th turnover of the ball game for Georgetown and the Friars. Can pull within one or get a tie on a three-point play. They've made 7 of their last 9 shots from the floor, says the stat beat. Here's Cartwright handling right of the key, well out on the perimeter. Georgetown stays in the zone. They find DeRozier outside the free throw line, drives left, leans in, goes over the jump hook, rolls it around and in.
DeRozier says, hey, I don't have the big guy Smith in there beating me up. I can take this over Hopkins. Makes a nice move. The Friars have figured out the zone, though, doing a nice job.
8 points for DeRozier in the game, and it's a one-point lead. Here's Smith Rivera. Has it right side for Copeland. Back to Smith Rivera in the center.
He's going to shoot it.
Uses a screen. Drives left underneath. Ball is Hopkins on the left side. Now back out to Trowick. Takes the three. Penetrates. Cut off. Top of the key. Copeland for three. No. Long rebound. Chase down. Lumumba has it for the Friars, and they can take the lead on this possession with 5 minutes to play.
Doing it with defense. Friars' zone has been very good. End to man to man.
So Cartwright takes his time. Looks over to Ed Cooling on the far sideline for the play call. Lumumba comes to the right wing for LaDante Hinton. Hinton turns. Looks at that zone. Gives it back to Cartwright on the right sideline. 15 to shoot. 4:50 to play. Cartwright takes the dribble back to the middle. Kicks the ball left corner for Hinton. Fakes, drives, goes up, saves it to DeRozier. Goes over the jump hook. Score!
Oh, what a nice move by DeRozier. Good pass, too, by LaDante as the defense collapsed on him. DeRozier makes a nice shot off the glass.
And the Friars retake a lead at 66-65, 4:28 to go.
Well, they've had a one-point lead 3 times in this game. Let's see if they can get a stop here.
Peek, top of the key, drives right for Trowick in front of his bench. Cut off, now goes down to the baseline and bowls over Lumumba. They're going to call a block on Junior. Oh, my goodness.
Well, they backed off Trowick. He just wants to go to the basket. He's not a guy looking to take the outside shot. He's taking the first shot of the game, made a 3, and he hasn't looked at one since. He wants to get to the glass. The junior tried to anticipate where he was going on that one. Got there a little late, and Trowick makes a nice move, gets the contact, gets to the line for 1-1.
First foul on Junior, but it's the 19th foul, so it is a 1-1 for Trowick. And he has hit 2 of 3 from the line for the ball game, and he swishes that one.
Well, Friars get it to 1 point. They just can't.
They can't get it any further.
Well, yeah. But hey, making a great job battling back to get it to this point. They were down 12 in this half.
That's right. It's a 20-6 run for the Friars before that Trowick free throw. Second shot is on the way, and it's no good. There's Junior with a rebound. We're tied at 66.
And all this being done with Chris Dunn on the bench, and he gets up to come to the scorer's table.
With 4 minutes to play, a little over that, 4:10. Here's DeRozier on the high post. Shares it with Ben Bentel. He's got Copeland on him, and Georgetown has pulled out of the zone. They've gone back to man-to-man.
That's good. Chris Dunn will be in the game in a minute.
Hinton has it. Now gives it back to Cartwright. Cartwright, guarded by Smith. Rivera rubs right off of the screen. Josh Smith also back in the game. Bentel in the right corner. Eight to shoot. Drives into the lane as it tipped away from behind. Picks it back up. DeRozier with three, with two. Drives, puts it up. Dumps
That's
it off
the way
with
you go
one
in there.
On the shot clock, and Carson is fouled.
That's the way you go strong. Don't go up there with that little layup. Go in there and try to dunk it on somebody. 7 feet. He picks up the foul right there. If he tries to lay that one up, John, he doesn't get the call.
Foul is on Copeland. The Friars will shoot free throws after the timeout with 3:46 left, and we're tied at 66. Holy moly. From Learfield Sports, this is Providence Friar Basketball. EC.org or call 1-800-283-8385 to make an appointment.
Earl Friar's shown a lot of character in this game, John. They've made 9 of their last 11 shots. They were down by 12. Looked like the momentum was all Georgetown. Friar's on a 20-7 run. And doing a good job of finally figuring out the zone. They went to the zone. Georgetown did the Friars didn't score for about 6 or 7 minutes, and then all of a sudden they made 7 out of 9 against the zone. And Georgetown has to go back to man-to-man. Perfect timing. Chris Dunn's back in the ball game with 4 fouls. No, he's not going to come back in the ball game. They're going to leave him out there. It must be another timeout coming here.
Nope, this is the last one.
All right, they're going to leave him out on the defensive side probably.
DeRozier has 2 shots, and the free throw is good, and the Friars take the lead, but they have not led by more than 1 tonight. This could be their biggest lead at 2. They've made 16 of 25 from the free throw line. Second shot, good, and the Friars Carson have a 2-point lead.
He's playing great, Carson DeRozier. He's playing good defense. He always plays good defense, but he's scoring in this one when the Friars need the points.
12 points for Carson tonight, and the Friars up 68-66. Right wing Copeland, now for Peak in front of his bench on the right wing. Comes back out to Copeland. Friars stay in a 2-3 zone with Cartwright and Lumumba out top. Smith Rivera comes left for Trawick. Trawick sideline left. Copeland jumper 16. No! Rebound Bentel has it for the Friars. And that is Ben's first career double-double.
Well, the game, the hope gets a little tighter when you're down at this point in the ballgame, John. They had easy time to say, Georgetown shooting those shots earlier.
So Cartwright handles on the right wing. Friars playing with the ball and the lead at 2 points for the first time tonight. Cartwright shares it out to Junior against Smith Rivera. Tight man-to-man for the Hoyas. Bounces left for Bentel. With 11 to shoot, Cartwright pops between the circles to grab the ball. Comes to the right. Cuts back to the left for LaDante. LaDante muscles his way inside. Jump hook. Rattles. No. Rebound. Bentel goes up and taken away by Smith Rivera.
What a rebound by Bentel, and Smith Rivera gets in there and takes it away.
Here's Smith Rivera. Trawick in the right wing for Peak in the corner. Penetrates into the lane. Stops. Kicks the ball back out for Smith Rivera.
Don't leave him.
Friars all over, and Peak again for Trawick on the right side in front of his bench. 2:34 to play. Bounces left. Smith Rivera feeds Copeland on the baseline. Copeland double team. Loses the ball. Stolen by Bentel.
Good job again getting it into Copeland, the freshman. Gets the turnover right there, taking away Smith Rivera from the perimeter. Big possession right here to get a score.
Cartwright walks it left to right into the fourth court. Friars going to measure some clock now with the ball in a 2-point lead. Lumumba, top of the key, back to Kyron. Against Georgetown's man-to-man, he's going to back it out between the circles. Gets the play call from Ed Cooley as he looks over to the far sideline. Shot clock already down to 9 seconds. Cartwright makes his move left. Looks for the wraparound. Puts up the runner off the rim. Bounces. No good. Rebound comes down to Copeland.
That was a good look by Cartwright. Made a nice shot. They just didn't make it.
Georgetown Trawick streaks to the right side and gets fouled by Cartwright as he falls hard to the floor under the basket. Cartwright will be called, should be called for the foul before the shot, and Trawick is really shaken up under the basket.
Well, he went up strong, and DeRozier just said, hey, you're not going to get the shot off. Cartwright picked up the foul, and it's just a little bit of acting there by Trawick. He goes in there with a reckless abandon, and he just tries to throw his body into everybody. And all DeRozier did was go straight up. I mean, they'll probably go check the monitor, but DeRozier just went straight up and went for the ball.
And he's rolled over on his back, laying down on the baseline to our left as both teams now go to their respective benches, and he's being helped to the to his feet by Devontae Smith Rivera, and he's okay.
Well, they're going to act, you know, they're going to, he's hamming it up over there. He felt like because of the way he landed, but that's the way he plays. He's a reckless abandon. I thought DeRozier, not because of the Providence radio, but he went up strong and tried to block the shot. He went for the ball. They're going to look at it. I'd be surprised if they call this a flagrant foul.
Well, they are going to check the monitor, so Paul Zelk goes over. Now Tom Eads comes over to join him. The foul on Cartwright was the 10th of the half. So it's a two-shot foul, regardless whether it was on the floor or whether it was in the act of shooting. It'll be two shots. Coach Cooley's
yelling at the official. Hey, the same thing happened down this end. You didn't call anything. LaDante Henton got hammered out there as he tried to split the double team. Went up for the shot, got pushed on the shot. He landed on the floor, no foul. And Trawick is just, he's a guy that just wants to go in and just throw his body at anybody, throw it up off the glass, and he gets to the foul line.
You knew that's what he was going to do. And any time he's going to touch the ball in the last 151 of this game, he's going to take the ball to the hoop and try to get to the line.
Right. He tries to go right. You got to take away that right hand if you can. But back off him. That's one guy you can back off. Make him take the outside shot. If he makes it, good for him. He's not a guy you have to worry about making that outside shot.
There is a discussion amongst the triumvirate of officials just in front of the scoring table near the mid-floor line as they have stepped away now from the monitor.
It's usually not good when they're over there discussing it like that because somebody's not agreeing with what's going on. And I mean, this is a big call. He gets two free throws and they get the ball back because of a flagrant foul.
That could turn the tide of the ball game.
Yeah, I mean, there's 1:51 to go. Fry's had two possessions in a row. Here we go. He's going to come over and explain. That means it's a flagrant foul.
Yeah, that's what I'm afraid of. At risk of the turnover. Yeah, there it is. And now the fire bench just erupts.
This is baloney, man. This is baloney.
They're calling a flagrant foul. Well, official Tom Eads is trying to explain to the television crew to our left, and we didn't get a heck of a lot of it. All we know is that Georgetown will shoot free throws and get possession of the ball. So a flagrant one called here with 1:51 left, and Ed Cooley
is absolutely
apoplectic with Pat Driscoll trying to explain it to him.
That's no guts.
Terrible, terrible call. But you're not going to get that kind of call, I think, on the road. You're just not.
Trawick's a wild man. He's just out there throwing his body against him. He acted that out. He the officials bid on it. This is a terrible call.
And this is going to change this ball game. Friars leading by two with 1:51 left. Georgetown will shoot two and then get the ball back.
Cooley's right. Cooley's yelling at the officials. What happened down this end when LaDante got hammered? He's saying...
And the fans are obviously looking now to get Ed Cooley a technical foul.
I agree with that. Well, I would agree with him anyway, but that's just a bad call. I mean, these guys, this is awful.
Especially when you have a call that is basically turning the momentum in the game around definitively with less than 2 minutes to play. The officials have taken the play away from the players.
These guys, unbelievable.
And so Trawick now is going to shoot two. With nobody around him, basket to our left. All the players are standing near the mid-floor line, and his free throw is no good. Ball don't lie.
Justice. Well, they get the ball back, though. But still, they get the ball back. I'm glad they coolly challenged that. I mean, many times the coaches say, okay, you looked at it, but that's not right. I mean, that's Trawick is an actor. He's done it the whole game. He just goes to the basket and just jumps at people. It creates contact. I mean, if you can get away with it, great.
Why is Smith Rivera shooting here? Because it was a technical foul? So Smith Rivera is now shooting two? We never had the explanation from the officials, and his first free throw is good. And that ties the score at 68. So why does he get two free throws? We've never had that explanation.
I have no idea why he gets two.
And the second shot is good, and now Georgetown has taken a one-point lead. So we're not sure why he got four free throws in a row and possession of the ball. Unfortunately, no one told us. Because the foul was what? In a bonus?
The first foul was in the bonus.
Was in the bonus. And then the flagrant on top of it. So that's what it was. First foul was on the floor. It was a two-shot bonus. And then the flagrant came afterwards. So that's why it's a four-point swing. Georgetown with the ball. 1:33 to go. And the Friars are down one. Smith Rivera with the ball outside the three-point stripe, feeds the post to Josh Smith, goes down low, blocked by DeRozier. Friars come up with the ball. Chris Dunn has it on the break, looking for the lead, and he holds up on the left wing. So at least we were able to get some explanation from Paul Zelk as he was running down the floor. Dunn feeds Henton, coming off the break, goes inside, and he's fouled as he goes to the hoop. No! Offensive foul is
this
called!
No, he's going to be overruled. He got to be overruled right here.
I think
Pat Driscoll had a regular foul.
Pat Driscoll is going to call what? The foul is on 24 of Georgetown, he says, Josh Smith.
That should have been the call. These two officials had it against Smith.
They had both. The other two officials had it against LaDante.
Yeah. No, the guy on the bottom there, Cisco, whatever his name is, the new guy, he had it against LaDante. They called that one against Smith. That two officials, Driscoll and the other guy, I don't know his name, he called it against Smith.
So LaDante goes to the line to shoot two free throws as Josh Smith picks up his fourth personal foul. They're going to say it's a one-and-one, not in the act of shooting.
That's when LaDante's at his best, John. Getting to the basket, creating some contact.
He's got a score here to tie it. Free throw is good for Hinton. Ties the score at 69. That was the 18th foul for the Hoyas.
Wow.
My goodness.
Big East basketball at its best right now.
For the lead. Good for LaDante, and the Friars lead by one, 70-69, 1:10 to play. My goodness gracious.
It's going to come down to a bad call, though. You know that.
Here is Trawick on the right wing. Peek now goes left for Isaac Copeland. Friars extend his zone out on the shooter. Peek centers right for Trawick. Right corner, Smith Rivera fakes the three. Doesn't get a shot off. Back out for Trawick. We're under a minute to go. Copeland between the circles for Trawick. Fakes right. Wants to go right. Cut off. Hands off Smith Rivera. Loses the ball. A reach-in foul is called. And it is called on LaDante. Hinton will put Smith Rivera at the line, shooting two with 45.9 seconds left.
Good play by Smith Rivera, splitting that double team. The Friars were worrying about him making the three-pointer. He's made a few deep ones in this game. He pumped fake and got them leaning forward, and he got them beat, and he reached across and picked up the foul.
So Devontae Smith Rivera, 2 of 2 at the line. He's an 85% foul shooter on the season, second in the Big East. And the free throw is nothing but net to tie the score at 70. He's got 9 points in the half, 20 points for the game to lead all scorers, the preseason player of the year in the Big East Conference. And the junior from Indianapolis for the lead. Got it. He's hit 4 in a row from the line. 30-second timeout is called on the floor by Georgetown with 45.9 left to set up their defense, and the Hoyas lead by 1.
Well, with 45.9 seconds to go, 35 on the shot clock, John, the Hoyas are going to get the ball back either down or up in the game. So Friars, Coach Cooley does a pretty good job of setting up plays to get his guys a good look. You know, the way LaDante's been playing here in the second half, he's hit some big threes, but I'd rather see him get something going to the basket, create some contact.
Right.
Looks like the officials might blow the whistle. You never know, though. It's pot luck with these guys tonight. They're not having a very good game either way, either side of the ball.
Yeah, we thought the play earlier that put Carson DeRozier at the foul line wasn't a good call as well, even though it went in Providence's favor.
He did. I mean, he lost the ball and they gave him a foul, but that flagrant foul call was just an awful call.
So each team has 2 timeouts remaining. Both teams are in the bonus, but Georgetown's in the double bonus on 10 Friar team fouls. Friars are in the 1-1 on 8 Georgetown fouls. 45.9 seconds left. Providence trails by 1.
Georgetown's going to stay in
his zone.
They're going to go zone here.
And here's Dunn with the basketball into the forecourt between the circles. Friars played well without Dunn for most of this second half with 4 fouls. We'll see what happens here. Jump pass to Hinton. Baseline right. A whistle and a foul on Smith.
No, they're calling on. Or they're going to call that on.
Is that on Josh Smith?
Call that
it
on.
Is on 2-4 Smith, and he is fouled out of the game, Joe. That's it for Joshua Smith. With 32 seconds left, Joshua Smith picks up his 5th foul.
Well, what happened was the Friars ran that play, John, along the baseline to get LaDante Hinton to come under the screen by DeRozier. DeRozier set the screen on the baseline on Smith, and he got free on the square. Dunn found him, but Smith, in the process, drew DeRozier out of bounds, and he picked up the foul.
So DeRozier will be going to the free throw line to shoot 1-1 with 32 seconds left, and Joshua Smith fouls out with 10 points along with 6 rebounds.
That's a big guy to get out of the game.
Yeah, but now you've got to make sure that your own big guy steps up and hits free throws here to put the pressure on the Hoyas.
And you bring Michael Hopkins in behind him. And Michael Hopkins, if you remember back in Providence, he missed 6 free throws in a row down the stretch. If the Friars can get the lead in this ball, the key shot obviously is the first one of the 1-1.
So Hopkins, as you said, Joe, replaces Smith with the 5 fouls. Carson DeRozier.
If DeRozier misses this,
has 12 points in the ball game, 2 of 2 from the foul line. a 69% free throw shooter from the line on the season.
He misses this. Fries have to foul
right
Hopkins
away.
Right away.
DeRozier, free throw, on the way. Bounces, stays. So he's hit three
Look
of three.
Trower. Trower's out of his mind. He's trying to slap five with DeRozier. And the guy's got a little, he's a little tight upstairs.
For the lead with 32 seconds left. DeRozier, shot, on the way. Got it!
Timeout, Coach Cooley. How about DeRozier? He's been playing awesome in this game.
He has 14 points. 10 of them have come in the second half. And now Ed Cooley will set the defense up for the Friars, who lead it 72-71 with 32 seconds left. Georgetown can take it right down to the final tick for a shot.
You know, it's funny. You watch all the little things that go on and, you know, outside the game. They're watching, you know, Trowick. Came over the first free throw. He bumped into DeRozier and tried to slap him five to try to distract him. The official told him, get out of there. And then he makes the shot, and Trower goes right over there again and tries to slap him five. The guy plays a reckless advantage. He's the kind of guy you want on your team, but he's the kind of guy you hate to play against is Trower.
So defensively, Hinton, DeRozier, Dunn with four fouls, Bentel and Lumumba in the ballgame for Providence. Offensively for Georgetown, Smith, Rivera, Copeland, Hopkins, Trowick, and Peak.
Well, the defense, if you'd ever need a stop, this is where you need one, right here.
And here comes Smith, Rivera into the forecourt. Right to left he goes to the right sideline. Down to 25 seconds. They can take the final shot. They trail by one. Smith, Rivera, top of the key. Trowick on the right wing. Kicks the ball back outside for Smith, Rivera. Friars collapse on him. He shakes off to the top of the key. Tries to spin to the left. Kicks the ball left wing. Ball is knocked away by Dunn. It goes out of bounds. But it's off of Chris with 11.8 seconds left. And John Thompson calls a timeout.
Well, they can look at that. They can look at that and see what happens.
And the Friars are going to ask the officials to look at the monitor.
Dunn thought he had that one. They can look at the monitor now under 2 minutes. They can take a look at that. If they request it, you got to take a look.
So the Friars are trying to get
Pat
the officials
Driscoll,
to do that.
He won't look at them. Look at them. You can take a look at that. You can look at the monitor. Look at what, Driscoll, what are you doing? He said, go ahead.
Now the officials are slowly going to move over to the scoring table on the far side, and they will check the monitor. So 11.8 left, 72-71, Friars by one. And the officials looking to see who the ball went off of on the baseline left of the basket.
Boy, I wish we had a monitor. I'd like to take a peek at that.
Well, looking at the television table down to our left, Joe, and it's really difficult to see, even from the angle that the replay has.
Well, Chris Dunn's expression either looked like he thought he had it
or he had it
out of bounds.
That's what I'm saying. So it's very, very difficult to tell, at least from the angle that we have here.
Steve,
I'm not sure that they're going to change it.
Coach Lapis over there, he's thinking that
they might
change
it. Yeah. We were looking at Steve Lapis, who's doing the analysis for the CBS Sports Network, and he's pointing to the monitor, but they're going to say it is Georgetown's ball. So the Hoyas are going to keep it with 11.8 left. They do have one timeout left. The Friars also have a timeout.
Well, you got to know where Smith Rivera is.
Both teams are in the double bonus.
And Trowick, if Trowick gets the ball, he's going to the basket. No question about it. And Smith Rivera, you got to take away his shot. You got to make sure he doesn't beat you.
Question is, do the officials on a drive, do they swallow the whistle or do they blow it?
I think they blow it.
Peak will inbound the ball.
Watch Campbell, too. He's had a couple of three-pointers in this
ballgame. He has. Campbell has checked in. Peak inbounds the ball, baseline left. Friars guarding away from the ball. And looking to inbound it, throws it a ball, and it's knocked away. Stolen by Providence! Dunn knocked it away! Saved it to Bentel, and Georgetown fouls with 9.8 seconds left!
What a great defensive setup. What they did was they put Dunn on the wing where he normally plays at the top of the zone. Friars play zone on that out-of-bounds play and put Dunn near the ball. And he's the guy who ends up stealing the ball, tipping it over to Bentel, who gets to go to the line now for two shots. That's the 10th team foul for Georgetown.
So you need to hit... Hopefully, well, if you hit them both, then Georgetown would have to have a three to tie. Bentel at the line has hit 6 of 7 in the ballgame.
Copeland,
the foul was called on Copeland, his second, team's 10th. First shot by Ben. Good! Ben Bentel having the game of his young life as Mikhail Hopkins checks in, replacing Isaac Copeland.
Look for somebody's probably going to call a timeout here if he knocks this free throw down.
It's a two-point Providence lead. Friars have hit 22 of 31 as a team from the free throw line. Second shot, Bentel. Got it! Three-point game. Georgetown can tie. Trowick looks for the inbounds. They find Smith Rivera in the backcourt. Up the right sideline. Dunn on top of him with five. Deep three. On the way. No good!
Norrie crossed over, dribble went left and took a great look. Just didn't knock the shot down. The Friars equaling out. What a ball game for the Friars to win.
Unbelievable. On the road, down by 13 points in the second half, Providence pulls the stunner, winning over 24th-ranked Georgetown in Washington, D.C. for the first time in 10 years and the first road win over a nationally ranked team on the road in 11 years. 74-71, the final. Our Santander Bank postgame wrap-up is coming up next from Learfield Sports. This is Providence Friar Basketball.